Okay, today we are playing a game on Anubis. We are playing Reinhardt on the first defense, and on the first attack, we play a little bit of Tracer, and then we're playing Winston for the rest of the game. So, let's look at our team. We've got Reinhardt, Zenyatta, Pharah, Soldier, Anna, and Zarya. So a very average team, basically. We've got Barrage and Graviton to combo with, and that's kind of it, but I mean, it's pretty good generally anyway. We can just run in there and swing. We've got Anna to throw the grenade in there. We've got a very average team, basically. I prefer Roadhog to Zarya, but, you know, whatever. It's all good. It's all fine. So, we're going to be standing up here, where we want to be standing. Hopefully Soldier comes and stands behind us. Anna's coming and standing behind us. Soldier's back there somewhere. Enemy team disappearing on the right-hand side, as they often do. This is like where you put the shield down. You'd already want to be putting the shield down, basically. When most of the team disappears around that doorway, you want to just put the shield down immediately, because all their DPS have already gone through the doorway at this point. So, really, there's not going to be that much left to block. There's going to be Orisa, but whatever, not the end of the world. And you're going to need your shield as full HP as possible, because when they go through that doorway, you're going to have to fight them over here. So, as soon as you see, like, most of their team disappear in that doorway, you usually want to just put or at least, like, their DPS disappear in there. You then want to just put the shield down immediately so it can be regenerating. So, now, we've said it was breaking, we're sitting back, we're waiting for it to regenerate. You could have waited for it to regen a little bit more than that, because, basically, like, I find Reinhardt players do this where they wait for it to be like 1,000 HP when they're waiting for it to regenerate and then they come back out. The thing is, because you don't want the shield to break, you usually have to take it down at like 200. So if you let it regenerate to 1,000, you only really have an 800-ish HP shield, which is worse than Orisa's shield, which is not exactly great. You usually want to just sit and wait for it to regenerate a little bit more. Because it's very easy when you're playing Reinhardt to get in this cycle where you get out of the way and you're like, alright, half is good enough, but it's not actually half, because you have to make sure it doesn't break at the same time, and they'll just chew through it so quickly that you're just gonna get out here and tank, like, a second of shots and have to get back out of the way again. Like, we didn't really, like, now we gotta get back out of the way again and wait for it to regenerate. I usually wait for it to regenerate to, like, 1,500 or 2,000, if possible, because 1,000 just isn't enough, usually. It's gonna break again so quickly. Wouldn't recommend just, like, turning the corner and swinging in, because their team is really high damage like this, and they're not really gonna come up to the doorway for you to swing at them. Just, like, poke your face in when you've got when you're waiting for your shield to regenerate, just poke in and use the fire strike, and then duck out of the way again. Their team's not gonna come up to the doorway that quickly, and you're just gonna take a bunch of damage as you poke around the corner. Right now we're purple, so that really fucking sucks, and we've got basically no shield, so we're having bad times right now. I would just get out of the way at this, like, just get out of the way, don't stand in the center around here. Fortunately, we're, like, winning this fight, it's not going terrible, so we don't have to jump off of the high ground. And, like, don't do that, you're still pretty close to being dead right now. You just gotta fall back and wait to get healed and for your shield to regenerate. Don't poke around the corner at, like, 100 HP or like, 200 HP, because really easy to suddenly die. And if you suddenly die, you're gonna lose the point. Anna slept somebody back here, we came back, we pinned them, great. Teamwork was employed. We've almost got Earth Shatter now. Enemy team is kind of scattered. We go in here for the Lucio. Wouldn't bother. No point. You're not going to get this Lucio. Like, this Lucio has to let you kill him, basically, which he's not going to do most of the time, so don't even bother coming in here. He actually does, like, let us kill him, as it would happen, but this Lucio you shouldn't actually get. Like, he just sits there on the healing aura. He should just immediately switch to speed and run away. Just, like, stand out there and, like, block for your team, because usually that's not going to work out. It works out in this situation, but, you know, Lucio, pretty squirrely guy, usually. This one just lets us kill him. So, we're in an awkward position where we're standing in the street right now. I wouldn't try and stand down here, I'd just be trying to get the team to go back up on the high ground again, because defending down here is pretty poor compared to just standing up on the high ground again, so, like, you know, I wouldn't bother standing around down there. Especially since the enemy team usually likes to go around the left-hand side. So now we're going to do this game again where we stand over here. Fortunately, they don't have a Reinhardt, so they're having a hard time pushing through this. Even though, like, they've gotten the head start in a few of these fights, they just don't have the presence necessary to get in. So this is a tragic waste of ultimates over here, because you'll notice we just used two ultimates to kill Anarissa, who we could have honestly just come in here and killed anyway if we knew she was that alone. So that's not a good use of company resources right there. And that's going to be, and that's very, very important, because now Tac Visor has happened behind us and he's been nano boosted. I think, well, he's got nano boosted after the Tac Visor had already ran out, so that's not exactly great. But now they're just going to kill us through sheer number of ultimates. We used two ultimates over there to kill the Orisa, and then we just got killed because they used more ultimates behind us and we couldn't fight them off, basically, because we were down two of our most... We were down two of our strongest ultimates in Nano Boost and Graviton, so, you know, shit happens, basically. Not much you can do about that one. That's the easiest way to throw on defense. You overcommit a bunch of ultimates that you didn't need to, and then they just kill you with ultimates. I do think Earth Shattering was the correct play to try and get the Reinhardt, to try and get the Soldier, but unfortunately they just beat us down anyway, because they just came in with like four ultimates and got through us. Fortunately, that means they don't have their ultimates to just snowball into this point, so that's good for us at least. So we've been talking about the last point this entire time. So they're coming in right now. They're gonna try and snowball in and just carry on with the momentum. You gotta try and resist the temptation to look over at the Soldier. Like, sometimes there's gonna be like one person behind you shooting at you, and the temptation to turn around is really, really strong, but you gotta be looking over here right now, because this is more, like, what's happening over there is more threatening. This Reinhardt doesn't have his Earth Shatter, because he only just changed to Reinhardt, so we don't have to worry about that, but he tries to pin us as soon as we turn away. You gotta just, like, not look at the one person behind you and just kind of hope your team deals with it, because it's really easy to just be like, oh fuck, who's that? And then you just get killed because you looked away. Then we get bumped into this really unfortunate position. We don't get pinned, so that's great, but we get bumped in really far. We try to pin somebody and it doesn't work. The play was probably to try and just charge out rather than in, because it's hard to, like, try and pin someone point-blank, basically, especially with, like, the area we were in. The play was probably just try and charge in this direction and, like, get back to your team instead. But you probably die regardless, because I can't imagine you actually getting out, regardless of where you charge. Because you got pushed into a pretty unfortunate position. Just, like, the way you prevent that is pretty much you don't look at the Soldier, and then you just bonk off the other Reinhardt when he charges in instead. Or, like, you know, you've got more warning he's coming and you get out of the way easier. But, like, you know, once you're in that far, you're probably not getting out. Fortunately, they don't have any ultimates to snowball this into, so our team is able to fight them off anyway. And we managed to get back out here, and we're halfway towards our Earth Shatter. Enemy Reinhardt is probably a little bit closer than us to his Earth Shatter at this point. Because he got to do damage during that fight, but we died. So he's probably, like, the same or a little bit ahead of us right now. So, you know, we got to be keeping track of that, because that's pretty important. So now we're just waiting for the enemy team to recollect and push in again. Tracer's down there, kind of being, like, annoying, but there's not much we can do about that. We should go in and, like, try to kill this Reinhardt right here, because he is basically by himself. Like, he's got he's got Discord on him. Everybody else is out the doorway. Tracer's down here on the right-hand side of us. Like, we could come in and more aggressively and try to kill this Reinhardt, but our team is going to kill him regardless, so it doesn't really matter. Zenyatta uses Transcendence really poorly, because he uses it to just save Roadhog's life, even though Roadhog's life wasn't worth Transcendence in that situation, really, because the enemy team wasn't looking like they were going to push in, but whatever, you can't do anything about what Zenyatta does. Shield should just be regenerating during this period of time, because we're not really blocking anything. Like, you don't even really need to be blocking over here right now, because you can just take it down right now, because basically everybody's disappeared. But even just this is not really threatening. You could be letting it regenerate over this period, because there's, like, most of our team is pretty tanky at this point, and now, we're only really blocking for Zarya at that point, so you could be letting it regenerate over this period. We get bubbled so the tracer bomb doesn't do anything to us, but we would have survived anyway, and it's unlikely we would have died to follow up. So Reinhardt at this point is probably pretty close to having his Earth shatter, but we're really close to having our Earth shatter as well. And he's kind of too low to really come in on us at this point. We just lost our Farer, which really sucks, but we have managed to build up our Earth shatter. Bunch of ultimates are just coming in on us right now. I'm not 100% on this Earth shatter because we don't really know what we're going to hit with it. It kind of just seems like, I'm going to hit this Zarya, and like, that's kind of seems like the only plan. We do end up getting a bunch of other people, but I'm not sure it's really for the right reason, because it seems like you just wanted to hit the Zarya, because you track her the whole way around, and we don't see anybody else. It's not worth just ulting the Zarya, unless we're like predicting they'd come up the staircase as well, but, you know, I'm not 100% on that Earth Shatter right there. And now our team is not really having a great time out here, but it's not going terribly, and this is a 2CP map, so we're still going to get out here quickly enough to like start fending this off, because they haven't gotten it super cleanly. Reinhardt just used his Earth Shatter over there, nothing we could do about it unless we came out the other doorway, but we can't possibly know that unless we're clairvoyant, so no point being upset about that one. We've been nano-boosted, we absorb a bunch of the damage, Reinhardt's like, oh fuck, this one's nano-boosted. We're really low HP, but we got to stand on the point, so this is fine. We're just blocking a bunch of damage. There's not much they can do to really kill us. Wouldn't take it down and start swinging in this situation. You just got to stay alive right now until your team gets to you. Lucio's gotten to us just now, but he's not going to heal us up super quickly. Like, you got to just keep it up at that point, because staying alive is more important. And then they end up breaking our barrier and we end up dying. But most of our team is reinforcing at this point anyway, so it's fine. But just keep your shield up in that situation. Staying alive is more important than getting 75 damage in on the Zarya at that point. And like enough of their threatening members were like soldier was still there, so we kind of, you know, it's kind of scary when you're only 200 HP. So, but we've managed to hold them off. We've reset now. We've got more of our ult than Reinhardt does, probably, because, well, no, wait, do we? Because he pinned us while we were nano-boosted, so, no, we're, like, the same then, probably. Because he actually gets less charge off of you when you've got damage reduction, so we're probably about the same ult charge as the Reinhardt. Because he died first, but he did pin us, so he got more, but we were damage reduced, so he's pretty close to ours, but we've probably got slightly more than him. So a fight's breaking out over here. Someone's been put to sleep, but they're too deep in for us to pin them, really. And their Reinhardt's coming in. This Reinhardt's probably got his ultimate at this point, because he got a bunch of swings on us right there, so he's probably got it, or he's very close to it at this point. So we've got to be careful of that, but he's coming in with more HP on his shield. We're getting a swing in right there. We've managed to build up our Earth Shatter, but we've been bumped way far away. We try to predict which way he's going to go. He goes the other way. Don't jump when you Earth Shatter, usually, because that just adds more time to it. And really, we just want to ult this soldier. I get the idea that you're probably trying to jump to the side so that you can get them and the soldier, but really just ulting the soldier is the important part right here, so I'd rather, instead of you jump and try to get all of them, you just ult the soldier and make sure you stop his tac visor. Because he's kind of too close to you to hold the shield up at that point as well, because he's just going to walk through the shield if you start trying to block it, because that's the dream, you can just block the tac visor, but he's right on top of us. So, maybe we're trying to do it for the Farah over there as well, but I'd rather you just basically make sure you shut down the tac visor, because tac visor is one of the most threatening ults in the game. So we've died, a bunch of our team have died, that really sucks, and we don't get out there to touch it again, which is unfortunate. You know, they've only got a minute and 19 seconds spare, so it's not unimaginable that we still beat them in this position, but it is going to be difficult. Anubis is kind of that way, you know, where sometimes it feels like more of a coin toss than anything else. So we're playing Tracer now. Someone on our team has been really fucking angsty about not having enough DPS, even though Roadhog is actually a DPS hero in disguise. I fucking hate. I try and tell people this, and they're like, no, we've got two DPS because Roadhog's basically a DPS. No, he's a tank. Tell me how Roadhog tanks, motherfucker. Tell me how he absorbs damage. He's the only tank in the game that can't build the damage blocked stat. And you're going to tell me he isn't basically another DPS with a lot of hit points. Motherfuckers don't know anything about this game. And that's people up in Masters. They're still fucking stupid. Every ELO is ELO hell, is the moral of the story. ELO hell doesn't exist because every ELO is ELO hell, and therefore everybody's in it. So, we're playing Tracer, we go forward, we step on a trap, we immediately die. That really sucks. You know, the only thing you can really say about this kind of thing is just, like, be more careful about where you're going. They're standing in a pretty unusual position, but I guess, like, the only thing you can really say is, like, look before you leap, basically. Because, you know, you're playing Tracer, you want to get behind them, so you kind of need to figure out where the majority of them are before you start going in, but, you know, not much to say about that. When we step forward on a trap and we die, all you can really do is not, to, like, just see it and not do that. So they're fighting up there. We're going to go around the backside. We're trying to get on the point to basically try and draw aggro back to us. But we get hit by a Junkrat bomb and it kills us, you know. Not much to say about that one other than dodge, but that's not helpful advice, you know. I'm not going to fixate on, like, mechanical things because I can't help you with that really, right? It's just like, and like, yeah, you're going on the point to try and draw aggro back, you know, fair enough. It's just, we get killed. So yeah, that sucks. Now they're kind of fighting us out here, so it's really difficult for us to really get through them without just dying, so we kind of have to wait for them to fall back, and now we're sneaking in the side over here. We start shooting at this soldier from really far away. Don't do this if you're playing Tracer, because the idea, like, you're so far away from the soldier, you're not going to do any damage to him by shooting him from this distance, and you're just going to give away the fact that you're behind him right now. If somebody doesn't look like they notice you're there, and you're playing a flanker, You want to just, like, not shoot at them and just get as close as possible and then start shooting them. Because generally when you're playing a flanker, you want to be closer to the person. So try not to just give yourself away like this. Better just, like, maybe if you don't shoot at him, you can just walk up the side of him and just, like, drill him in the head and kill him. But, you know, there's a bunch of people coming back up there as well, so that probably doesn't happen either. And right now we're basically just trying to draw aggro back towards us, which is fair enough. We didn't have our recall, so we're blinking back over here to get the large health kit. We take a pretty long route to get there, because we blink all the way around the outside, rather than just blinking into this and then blinking into the doorway. So we go an unnecessarily long way around. Better to just, like, use your blinks to go this way, rather than blinking all the way down the hallway. So, but our recall was down, so we had to get out of the way, basically. So, now we're coming back around. There's a fight happening over here, so now's our time. We've found their Lucio, but it's really hard to kill Lucio as Tracer unless you're, like, really, really good at tracking. So, you know, we don't manage to kill the Lucio. Not that surprising, it's hard to kill Lucio. Especially after he's been buffed now, where he's, like, even more annoying to deal with as Tracer. So we recall to build up HP right here. Everybody's kind of right on top of each other, and soldiers using TAC Visor right now, so it's going to be difficult for us to really get anything done. And honestly, the play is probably just pull out sooner. Like, right now, if we see, but, like, soldiers also using TAC Visor behind us, so we probably don't get out regardless. You know, this is one of those games where it's really hard for me to imagine you winning this game, no matter how well you play, because so many things are going wrong in so many places during this game. That you're gonna have to play phenomenally well to do it right now. Like, you're playing Tracer right now, who is the best hero in the game to solo carry on, but, you know, there's only so much you can do at the same time. We've got Pulse Bomb now. We're gonna change to a tank, but we have Pulse Bomb right now, so we want to use that first. You know, fair enough. Unfortunate, like, it's very unfortunate that basically the enemy team keeps turning around to fight us, and then the rest of our team is kind of still getting fucked on the front line even when we're drawing aggro backwards, so, you know, this is what I'm saying. Now, I know from what you were saying at the time, the plan was to just stick this Zarya, but you noticed a Junkrat trap right in front of you at the same time, and it kind of fucked you up. At least that's what it sounded like was happening, but, yeah, Not a great pulse bomb, but, I mean, we basically were only coming out here to try and pulse bomb something. It's a shame we don't have our pulse bomb right now. But he dies regardless, but I would have definitely come up the staircase and been like, stick, got him, and then I'm out. I'm not very good at Tracer, though, so, you know, that might be bad of me. But Junkrat comes in, he kills us, we're gonna change to, Winston. I'm not really fixating too much on this Tracer's thing, because I don't see you play Tracer very often. Like, I've seen you play a bunch of times, and I don't really see you play Tracer very often. And, like, a lot of the stuff that's happened has been, like, more mechanical side than anything else, which I can't really help you with. Like, saying dodge the Junkrat isn't exactly helpful advice, you know? So I'm not really focusing on this, like, 2 minutes of Tracer footage that much. Just so that we can get back to, like, the bracket of heroes that I know you play more frequently, quicker, basically. So, now we're playing Winston, pretty good against their team. They don't have anything that can really threaten us that much. We're coming in right now, we've got Sound Barrier on us. This Graviton wasn't very good, but we ended up getting sucked into it. And then Earth Shatter comes across us on the backside. I mean, you know, like, we come in and both, like, the people that we really want to focus are already dead, Soldier and Junkrat, so now we basically do what, just want to stand on the point and do damage to people. We come too close to the Graviton and we get pulled into that, which is unfortunate, and we're just outside of our bubble so that we get Earth Shattered. You know, and then he comes in with the Nano Boost, but all of this is still happening over here as well. Then we get rezzed as well, because we've got Mercy on our team, so we're gonna get this point anyway, because we came in here with a bunch of ultimates. Like, we just threw a lot of ultimates at this point, and we got it. Which is usually how playing attack goes. And there's not much more we could have done, because basically the people we already wanted, that we wanted to focus, were already dead when we arrived. So all we could really do better than that was either, like, basically not get sucked into the Graviton, or if we know we're gonna get sucked into the Graviton, just wait to put the bubble on top of us when we're in it, because we end up just outside of the bubble as well. But other than that, there's not much two more you could do in there, because the people you want to focus, they're already dead. Not really sure about putting the bubble right there. Winston's bubble is really fucking fragile. It's 600 HP. 600, 700? I'm pretty sure it's 600 HP. It doesn't really block anything. It breaks immediately, so you don't really use it in this situation. Unless you're doing, like, the cheesy, like, Winston, Orisa, Reinhardt thing, where you just have constant barriers up. And, like, it just doesn't really look like it's gonna get a lot done right there. Especially our team comp. Like, our team comp is really short range, really dive right now, so, you know, nobody's really gonna stand in that bubble anyway. And now, you know, we're not going to have it the second we go in on this fight instead. We have to, and because we come in here with our bubble not quite up, we end up getting tranked pretty easy. Now we basically want to get out, like, basically, because we're low HP. We came down here to try and get the health kit. It's not there. This is just where we jump out. You're playing Winston, like, we go back in with 150 HP. You could just look back over there and jump away, because you have to back out as soon as you get low HP and you're playing a tank, because you're so, tanks are so easy to hit that once you're like 200 HP or below, you just can't really show your face anymore, because you're probably going to immediately die. And our jump was off cooldown. We could have jumped back over to our supports and had them heal us up. Instead, we die and now we have to come all the way back again. We're pretty close to having Primal Rage. Primal Rage charges pretty quickly, so we're probably going to get it during the next fight if we don't get to build it up before then. We're trying to push in on the left-hand side, which is definitely the better place for us to try and push in from. Reinhardt misses his pin. Put the bubble over him. Sound barrier. We're purple right now, but we've got the sound barrier on us, so we still come in. And then we wait for the purple to come off us, and we Primal Rage. Great. Fun fact, not many people know about Primal Rage and the grenade. If you ult, and you're low HP, if you Primal Rage with the purple on you, you don't get the full 1,000 hit points, because it heals 500 hit points and then gives you 500 hit points. So if you use it when the purple's on you, you don't heal those 500 hit points, you only gain the 500 extra hit points. So, fun fact about that, so good thing we wait for that to fall off. And now we're swinging around, we're trying to push people off of the point. I find it really difficult to really keep track of things when I'm in Primal Rage. I wish the camera shifted to third person view when you're using Primal Rage, because it's so hard to keep track of what's actually happening. You're pushing people around, you're jumping fucking everywhere, like, I get really disorientated. But what we really want to do is we want to try and put somebody in the fuck corner and, like, beat them to death. Like, we're disrupting a lot of people right now. But we also see this soldier, who is someone we want to focus. Soldier is on top of, high on our list of priorities. Oh, God, excuse me. He puts himself right in front of the closet, behind us. And I'm trying to find, like, the point where we see it. Like, right here, he just walks right in front of that doorway. We could get him in there and just, like, kill him in the back. But by the time we realize that, it's too late. We got Earth shattered, and then we got pinned right as Primal Rage ended. Feels bad, man. We do a lot of disruption, so that's great, but, you know, you really want to be able to, like, disrupt them, then pick, like, push them all away, and then just beat the shit out of one of the really high-priority people, like, you know, Mercy, somebody like that. They didn't have a Mercy, so it's basically, one of the other healers, or Soldier, or Junkrat. Sometimes you get to beat on a tank as well, sometimes you're in the really scary position where, like, there's nano-boosted Reinhardt, and you have to, like, hold him in the corner so he doesn't kill everybody, but boy does he still kill you anyway, and that feels pretty bad. So, we're coming around the backside, over here, and, you know, our team, you know, a lot of these fights were coming in from, like, different areas, which is unfortunate. Like, our team comp is really awkward, because we've got Pharah and we've got Reaper. So it's like, we don't really want to play Reinhardt because there's nobody to stand behind us. And we want to, like, bully around their long range as Winston, but it's really difficult for us to, like, push in and fight people because we're coming from so many different areas that it's hard to get, like, a unified push going because it's like, we're coming over here, Reaper's in the caves, the rest of them are coming down the middle, like, you know, it's very awkward to get, like, a unified push going in with our team comp. And I'd probably change to Roadhog in this position, because nobody's going to stand behind our shield when we're playing Reinhardt right now, so there's no point playing Reinhardt, really. So I think I'd change to Roadhog, because then we can try and, like, beat down the Reinhardt shield, and we can still do the same basic thing that we want to do as Winston, which is we want to pick off their squishy backline, because, you know, we could, like, come around and just, like, pull them out of position with the hook, you know, play Roadhog, basically. Because it's very difficult for us to, like, get our team to go in together, basically, because of the way our team comp is. So we've been Gravitoned over here. There's not a lot you can do about that one, unless you're playing D.Va. We do still have a Reinhardt as well, so, I mean, that's another thing. If we're playing, like, Reinhardt, or we could play Zarya. Zarya would be pretty good, because we can combo, Graviton with Death Blossom or Barrage, and support our Reinhardt. Or we could do, like, the same thing we were just talking about with the Roadhog. Winston, you know, he's a little bit more awkward because it's hard to get our team to go in together is what I'm really seeing from this game. And right there we're low HP, we step on a trap we couldn't see because it was behind us, and we die to the trap, which always feels bad, man. You know, it happens. So yeah, it's like, you know, our team comp's really awkward, basically. You know, like, I look at this team and I'm like, man, this is an ugly fucking team right here. And I think to myself, it is going to be really hard for us to kill people because, like, the most consistent DPS on our team is Pharah. Reaper has to get, like, Reaper is not good against the team that they have because all, like, he has to get so close to these people that it's just really hard for him to do, especially on Anubis where they're, like, really knit together usually. Because it's like, I don't know, some people think that, like, Reaper counters Soldier, exact opposite, Soldier counters Reaper, because he just drills him to death from outside of Reaper's range. Reaper has to sneak up on him. Like, Junkrat, it's going to be difficult for a Reaper to approach a Junkrat, and even if he does, he just throws the mine in his face and gets away. Anna can trank him, and he can just get pinned. Like, Zarya can save the person he's trying to assassinate by bubbling them. Like, Reaper is not very good against this team comp. So we're basically only playing with one DPS, which is Pharah. So I look at this team and I think to myself, I'd probably be better off playing Roadhog so I can try and make up for the DPS that we're going to be lacking because we don't have, like, a Soldier or a McCree on our team, you know, more consistent DPS. So, or, like, Zarya to try and, like, facilitate Reaper and Pharah more. You know, it's just, it's awkward with Winston, because it's going to be hard to actually, like, do enough damage to really kill these people when we dive in. But I'm not going to bother to fixate too much on that one. I try to, like, avoid, you know, switching advice, because usually I'm just like, all right, you showed me this hero, you want to know about this hero, so let's talk about this hero. But I do think in this situation, Winston's going to be really hard to work with, basically. So we're coming in now. Our team's gone in. We got here just in time to take part, but Tyre rolls out and kills us. You know, we're playing Winston. All you can really do is, like, try and jump away from the Tyre. Basically, like, you hear the Tyre coming and you're like, fuck it, I'm out. But either way, you know, they fend us off with ultimates. Tac Visor still happens. We're probably not likely to stop that. There's nothing we can really do to try and break the Tyre, and our bubble was still on cooldown, so we can't try and contain it either. You know, it's awkward. Yeah, this is what I'm saying. Like, I watch this game through, and honestly, I watch it, and I'm like, there's not too much more you could honestly do in this game. Like, there's a lot of parts that are failing in this machine, so it's like, you're gonna have to play really fucking well to really balance this out. And this is also what I'm saying, Roadhog or Zarya, because they have more control than Winston does, basically. So, we've got one push left in us right now, and we're communicating to our team that we're waiting for as long as possible to jump in, basically. You know, that's what you do. Yeah, we're going around the backside, and we do go in as late as possible. Reapers managed to kill Anna with Death Blossom, and that's it. We've managed to build up Primal Rage. We're trying to just disrupt. We've pushed, you know, we're not really focusing anyone down. We're basically just trying to push everyone around and disrupt this fight, which is fair enough. But we do want to kind of try and pick out, like, one important person and try to fuck with them. Because the idea is you split the team up and then you beat down the one person that's really high priority. So, Primal Rage has run out. We disrupted a bunch of people. We didn't really kill anybody. We're really low HP, but we have to keep standing on the point. We get Earth Shattered. Feels bad. Do we get rezzed? I'm pretty sure we get rezzed. Because we do win this round. We do manage to actually get round to another round. Or do they just... No, we get rezzed. Okay. So we're back up. Tyre explodes, doesn't kill us this time. Things are starting to look up, actually, like we're slowly starting to get through this fight. We don't really want to try and kill, we shouldn't really be trying to kill this, Reinhardt in this position, because people more qualified to kill Reinhardt than us are already on that. Like, we see Junkrat in that doorway behind us. He is more of our area than the tanks over here. We want to focus down the long-range squishy people. We should be trying to bully this Junkrat rather than the two tanks, because Reaper and Reinhardt are more qualified to do that than us. We should be trying to kill the Junkrat, because we're more qualified to do that than them. But, you know, that's a small thing, because now we're starting to win this fight pretty convincingly. Nano-boosted Soldier comes out, but we're all here and not feeling pressured right now, so we get to just basically overwhelm him. Very poor Earth Shatter from our Reinhardt, but, like, we've basically won this point. We're just going through the 2CP thing now, where they're slowly managing to stall it out, and we're like, oh god, Jesus Christ, we gotta get all these people off of here. And, you know, we're basically just killing them one by one as they arrive right now, so, you know, there's not much we can do here. The only thing we could have done better during this fight, really, is, like, try and bully someone specific during, like, split them up and then try to kill one person in Primal Rage that's really important, and instead of trying to kill the tanks, we turn and focus Junkrat instead, because he's our thing. So, you know, nightmare situation. They've got a minute and 19 seconds. They only need to capture 0.1% and they are going to win. So we have to be standing on the point 100% of the time. We also decide not to play Roadhog, basically because we're afraid of, like, pulling people onto the point and them capturing it. So we decide to play Winston. I think Roadhog was probably still the better choice, just because what they're probably likely to do, because they know they only need to get 0.1% and they'll win. What's probably going to happen is a bunch of people are going to try and sprint at the point and touch it. So I would still pick Roadhog, because you can stand on the point. Roadhog's got, like, more staying power than Winston generally, because Winston is a very squishy tank, for the most part. Roadhog probably has more staying power, and you can just pick off the people as they come in, because they are probably going to basically come in here with a dive comp and just try to touch it, Winston is not that good at stopping dive because he's dive himself. He's, you know, he's not gonna fend off a dive. Roadhog's better at fending off dive than Winston is, and you can just try and pick people off as they come in. Basically, the fear was you'd pull people onto the point, and they'd capture it. But Roadhog's just so much better at killing people and fending off dive than Winston that I think he would have been a better pick anyway. Zarya also possibly as well, but with only a minute and 19 seconds left, it's going to be pretty hard to build up a Graviton during that period of time, and Zarya isn't as good at stopping dive as Roadhog is. Alternatively, you could also pick D.Va, because D.Va is just difficult to kill quickly, and self-destruct charges up reasonably quickly. I think Winston was probably the weakest tank you could pick in this situation, because he himself is the worst at fending off dive. And that's exactly what starts happening. They start coming in here with a lot of dive. They're on the point basically immediately. Bastion's managed to kill their Pharah, but then their Roadhog just kills us, and I don't think we get back. No, we get back in time once, I believe. I'm pretty sure we get back once, but we die again really quickly when we get back there, because they're just diving on, like, they're full die. They've got full aggressive team coming in here. Yeah, we get back this first time, and we're, like, saying to our team, like, just keep touching it, just keep touching it. So we jump down, and there's a Roadhog here. That's really scary, but we have to keep touching the point, so we don't have the freedom to, like, back off from him. And we're getting hooked. Oh god, he's gonna do this. Oh god, there's not really a lot that we can do about it. You're playing, like, you're Winston against Roadhog right there. There's really nothing you can do. That's one of the, like, hardest counters in the game, pretty much. So now we gotta get back to the point. We don't make it back this time. You know, they only have to touch it for 0.1 seconds. That's exactly what they do. So yeah, like, you know, if you, I think you can see the, like, even if you were just Roadhog right there at the end, I mean, maybe you're not even alive at that point, but you'd, like, be able to stop his whole hog. Maybe you kill him. You probably kill the Lucio, because he came up really aggressively at the start of that round. Like, I don't think Winston was the best pick you could have made right there, basically. I think most other tanks would have been a stronger pick for that situation, but also, realistically, at the same time, you've got to defend for a minute and 20 seconds, almost, and they only need to get 0.1%. It's hard to imagine pulling off that kind of hold on Anubis, because you have to stand on the point the entire time, and it's a lot harder to stand on the point on Anubis than up on the high ground. You know, it's a problem. So, you know, this is what I watched this game through, and honestly, I think to myself, it's going to be difficult for you to pull this one off. The thing that stood out to me the most was, like, shield management with Reinhardt, because it's like, you're putting, you know, I know how it is. It's really hard to, it's hard to be like, oh, fuck, they're trying to come in right now. I gotta come out here and just start, like, holding the shield up. But, like, you've gotta let it regenerate to a decent amount. 1,000 HP is just not usually enough, because it's just gonna break so quickly. And it's not really 1,000 hit points, because you don't want to let the shield break. I don't know, this took me a while to really, like, think, like, internalize and get used to, but, like, you feel really pressured to do it. You're like, I'm the main tank, I gotta come out and stand here, because they're trying, like, throwing shit in. But you just gotta sit and wait for it to regenerate more than that, basically. The exception is if you're gonna lose the choke point if you don't come out and stand in it right now, then you probably want to come out and stand on it, even if your shield is less HP than you want it to be, because holding choke points is pretty important in this game. But if they're just, like, throwing shit in the doorway, you have to just be like, okay, I'm just gonna sit, and I'm gonna wait for it to be a decent HP, and then I'm gonna come out again. I'm just gonna, like, come out and, like, throw fire strikes in, hit people if they try and come through the doorway, you know, and then I'm gonna wait for it to be a decent amount, and then I'm gonna come and stand in it again. Because it doesn't really help if you regenerate enough, if you regenerate just, like, 1,000 hit points, it doesn't really help if you then have to just come out and stand in the doorway for 2 seconds and then you have to get out of the way again because it's breaking so fast, that doesn't really help. You're just kind of, you know, you're being, you're playing a really weak Reinhardt at that point where you're relieving pressure for like 2 seconds, but then you have to get out of the way again immediately. It's better to just wait like the extra second or two to let it regenerate up to a higher hit points and then come and stand in it, because then you can actually stand in it for like six or like, if you know, if it's really concentrated fire, it's going to be like 6 or 7 seconds usually instead of like 2 seconds. You know, that's a pretty big increase, right? You know, it doesn't seem like it, but that's quite a lot in this game where a lot can happen really quickly. And it's just like, as soon as nothing really threatening is happening, you just want to take your shield down and let it be regenerating. Like, as soon as they disappear in the doorway, you just, like, take it down immediately, because you're going to need to have it as high as possible for when they try and push through the doorway. And just, like, you know, if it's not really a threatening force that's staring you down, you don't really need to have it up either. You can just let it be regenerating over that period instead, because if it's not... because... I mean, there's this thing where people say you shouldn't let people hit your shield for free, which I think is a bad way to put it, because that implies you can punish people for shooting your shield, which you really can't. But the idea is that if you're not blocking damage, or there's nothing for the enemy team, like if you're not protecting anything and there's nothing for the enemy team to really be shooting at, you don't want to put your shield up, because then you're giving them something to shoot at, right? So the idea is, as soon as nobody's really standing behind you, you can just stand out of the way and take the shield down and let it be regenerating. And if nothing too threatening is staring at you, like if it's just one or two of their team and they're not going to just like immediately kill someone. Like if it's like, if there's like a Widowmaker over there, yeah, that's threatening enough that you still have to hold up the shield because she can one-shot people. But if it's like a soldier, that's, or like, Azaria and a soldier, that's not as threatening. You don't necessarily need to be holding it up at that point, because it's not like those two people are going to run into six of you and kill you. Like, it's not that threatening, so you can let it be regenerating instead. That's like the biggest thing I saw in this game, because by the point we're playing Winston, you know, it's like things are going really badly, and at that point it's like target prioritization as far as I see it, because you know, we come in with the Primal Rage, and we're just like, all right, I'm just going to keep pushing people around. We, like, try to kill the tanks instead of, like, focusing on the Junkrat, who's more our thing. So it's like, I think with Winston, it's like a target prioritization thing. Like, I find it difficult to pull useful information from this game, because it's hard to imagine you playing well enough to win this game. But the thing that stands out to me for Reinhardt is shield management, and the thing that stands out to me for Winston is target prioritization, where we're not... really picking on the people that we want to be picking on, but at the same time, it's difficult to pick on those people on Anubis, because second point, the enemy team is like really closely knit together, so it's very difficult to like get on somebody out of position and like really bully them around. So it's hard to do that on Anubis as well, but you can kind of see some, like, not great target prioritization in this game as well. So those are the two things that stand out to me in this game. And, like, the Tracer stuff, it's, like, mostly mechanical things that I can't really help you with. I think everything you were trying to do was fine. It's just, like, mechanical errors on that side, which I can't really help you with. That's just kind of, like... I can't tell you how to track. You have to get better at that personally, right? I can't tell you how to throw a pulse bomb. I can only tell you who you should throw the pulse bomb at, you know, which is usually the squishy people, obviously. So, you know, hopefully you found this video helpful. Thank you very much for watching. If you did, if you have any questions, feel free to ask. I'm more than happy to answer. And I hope you found the video helpful, even though, you know, it's kind of an awkward game, honestly. You know, sorry. Hopefully you found it helpful.